Thank you. I don't know how to move it up the stand, so I'll hold it. It might be a little bit easier. But actually, I had some things prepared to say, and unfortunately, I followed Bill, who brought up a lot of the points I was going to, like some of the great things that unions have brought us, such as weekends. You know,
eight-hour day,
40-hour week. 100 years ago, people worked 60 hours a week. We didn't have anything such as weekends. And I am, by the way, I'm not sure if I said, but I'm the chair of the Riverside County Democratic Party, the Democratic Central Committee. And I am a union member. I've been a union member my whole life. I was a Teamster when I was 19 years old, working part-time for UPS, going to college. And I was a union steward at that time when I was 19 and 20, and at UPS. And I've been a union member my whole life. I'm a CTA member, but my CTA membership has an R after it because I was lucky enough to have been a union member long enough to have retired last year. So I have an R after my name. I'm CTA retired. And Bill talked about a lot of the things I wanted to talk about. One thing I can talk about is what the union did for me personally, and that was CTA. When I was teaching was a second career, and I was a new teacher in Hemet Unified School District, and I ran up against a principal who, to be kind, wasn't a very nice person. And he has since, he was asked by the school district finally to either retire or be fired, so he's gone, and I did outlast him, so that was one good thing. But as a new teacher in the district, the first couple of years, you don't have tenure, you don't have very many rights as a teacher. And this principal decided to do some things that were illegal against federal law, against state ed code. I was a special ed teacher, so I was covered pretty well on class size requirements, caseload. As a resource teacher, your caseload can be 28. It can't be 29 ever for 1 minute. The limit's 28. He tried to go around that, and the way they had it planned, my caseload would have been, right in the very beginning, would have been about 35, which isn't manageable, especially not manageable for a new teacher. 28 is a lot with all the work you have to do, and special ed, all the paperwork and everything. He tried to take me to 35. He tried to combine the resource classroom into the SDC classroom, which violated ed code by the amount of square feet that must be allowed per student. And the only reason I knew these things, I knew I was being abused, but I didn't know how badly until I talked to one of the Hemet Teachers Association reps, who is also a member of the CTA and NEA. And he told me, he said, they can't do that. They absolutely can't do that. And, you know, we have to fight this. And so with his help, not really, having a hard time on my own with it, but he came in and with the weight of the CTA behind me, got everything stopped, and my caseload stayed below 28 the rest of the time in the district. And it was just something I could never, ever have done on my own. So that was one thing CTA did. Something else I looked up today, just since I was a teacher in Hemet Unified, I wanted to see how much some of the overpaid people are making, the overpaid teachers that we're talking about in Wisconsin and Ohio and Indiana. Locally in Hemet, where the cost of living is less than a lot of places, but not less than it is in Ohio or places like that. With a bachelor's degree and 8 years of experience, you're making, this is without a master's or any further, but after 16, 17, 18 years of education, teaching credential, working who knows how many hours a week with, you know, class sizes now of 40 plus, grading papers, doing lesson plans, things like that, who knows how many. But for all this, for the years of experience, for the education, you're being paid right at $50,000 a year.
You're rich.
Of course, with the exorbitant benefits. But these are the kind of people that are being attacked by the people in Wisconsin, Ohio, Walker, Kasich in Ohio, people like that, who probably never had to live on $50,000 a year, I'm sure, and wouldn't know where to begin if they did. And so these are the people that I'm glad we're here to support, and thank you everyone for being here, and let's go forward together. Thank you.